Hey folks, Adam Savage here in my cave with a tool tip that I'm pretty excited about. I was actually trying to think about where to begin with the story about this tool tip, but I don't think I have to go anywhere specific with that story. Modern surgery is amazing. The things that surgeons can currently do is astounding. I have a member of my family who, as a young girl, one of her legs was longer than the others, and doctors were able to lengthen one of her legs using a fixator and a few operations. It was not easy on this poor family member, but oh my God, what they achieved is astounding. Arthroscopic surgery, where they make a tiny incision and all the surgical tubes and stuff goes through one tiny incision rather than opening up, cracking up someone's whole chest. Totally amazing. And one of the key pieces of equipment that surgeons use for arthroscopic surgery is an endoscope. And an endoscope is a camera on a flexible wire or medium that allows it to go into a place, and it's a super tiny camera. Now, surgical endoscopes are expensive as all get out, and they should be. They're super high-end pieces of equipment. And there have been some consumer products that are a little more affordable. Black & Decker had a thing called a sea snake, which weirdly is one of the only gifts Jamie Hyneman ever bought me. But it's a camera on the end of a flexible arm and a screen that you can look at it through. And it's pretty cool. I've used it to source some problems in tiny crawl spaces in my house, and very useful. But like a lot of other things, the advances in miniaturized electronics and better smaller cameras, which has been fomented by the smartphone industry, means that there's never been a time to be a consumer owner of an endoscope than right now, because on Amazon, you can go purchase this endoscope, which is a 2-meter arm whose end is, wait a second, I actually haven't even measured this, whose end is exactly 1/4 inch in diameter. That is how small the end of this camera is. And this puppy is $30. Okay. Yeah. No. This one is exciting. I've been keeping up with endoscopes, and what I've been finding over the past few years is that they've been getting smaller and thinner and better. But like as late as maybe a year ago, the last time I went and checked, they were still pretty fat in terms of the business end. And you know, I want something that can go through a very small hole. And also their interface was not trivial, but this one, Nidaj is the name of this. I don't know how you pronounce it. Nidegi? I don't know. But at any rate, we'll include a link in the comments below. This one does not even plug into your camera. You turn it on and the light goes on and it creates its own wireless network. So I did this morning. You open your phone, you open your Wi-Fi, and you sign in to the network created by this piece, and then you go, the software is called HD Wi-Fi. Here it is, that it's opening up, and I think you can see what I've got going on here. Yeah, look at that. Okay, so it's on its side, there we go. Yeah, okay, so, hold on. There you are. Look at this. Okay, here we go. Okay, I am not going to subject you to footage from the inside of my mouth. That would be horrifying. However, I am going to press record on this. Yeah, so now it's recording, and I will take you on a journey into my shoe. Yeah, here we go. Now, let's say that you are, yeah, here we go. Okay, so I'm gonna go in. Oh yeah, this is like a nature documentary investigating a, like the lair of a beaver or a woodchuck or something.
Yeah, you can see where my big toe is. Wow. You know, I'll bet a podiatrist could tell a lot by the wear and tear on the inserts in my Blundstone boots. But, dude, you got to be ready for what you're going to see when you use an endoscope. We heard noises in this crawl space in our kitchen. In our kitchen, and corner cabinets are a nightmare. And sometimes your cabinet maker just makes a cabinet here and a cabinet here, but there's this whole blank space between them that no one can get to. I stuck an endoscope in there a couple of years ago, the sea snake. And what I saw was two dead rats that had totally mummified, that had probably died there 20 years ago in that same little crawl space. So you got to be ready for what you're going to see. But dude, this is crazy great. You can actually change the brightness of the light. Let's see here. I think you can, yep. You can make it brighter or you can turn it off entirely. And yeah, there it is. I think I'm actually going to zoom into the camera here and see if I can't get. Oh yeah, there we go. All right, let's try and get the video effect going here. Oh, it doesn't like that much image processing. Ooh. Oh, hey, you know, putting my face so close to my shoe, it reminded me how much my feet stink today. Not just today, just at the end of the day. It's the end of the day. I've been walking around all day. $30, swear to God, get thee an endoscope and start exploring the mysteries of places you formerly could not get a camera in. This thing is so much fun. I can't wait to see what you guys film with this incredible tool. Thanks so much for joining me for this tool tip. I will see you next time. Oh, I almost forgot. There's one other aspect to this endoscope that is super cool. It comes with some attachments out on the end. It comes with a right angle mirror, so you can look at right angles to where you're going, which is actually super useful. The app for it allows you to shift the image in the app, which frankly is a huge advancement over previous consumer level endoscopes. This is definitely thinner than anyone I've used before, which is a huge bonus. But that app feature of being able to turn the camera, because the orientation of this camera is very hard to maintain on an endoscope. And then third, oh, there's an attachment of a little hook on here. So this is 2 meters long. They actually make even much longer endoscopes. But let's say you've dropped your keys down a sewer. You can put the hook on this camera and you can see the hook and you can use it to boop, get your keys and pull them back out of the sewer. I've just invented this whole reality once you drop your keys in a sewer, because it happened to me once. Yeah, I wished I'd had an endoscope. Yes, I wanted to make sure you knew those features before I wrap this video.